So you, the first time you play against Penguinmon, you do not need a fish, but every other time you play against him, you need a fish. But since I'm pretty good at curling, I'm probably not gonna lose, but I did save state just in case something does happen.
So if you lose here, you need a fish to play him again?
Yeah, or I can just save state. But I've actually never lost a curling match before. At least I don't think so. I'm pretty sure I've never lost a curling match before. I'm pretty good at this one.
Looks like you kind of overshot that one a bit.
I realized the second that I threw it that it was too much power.
Looks like Penguin Mon's gonna take advantage of that.
Don't worry. No need to worry. So I'm going to full blast this all the way down there. Oh, that was one away from full blast, but that's still fine. It should still go on the good.
This is supposed to be curling, but Bergermon's not sweeping the ice for you. He's not regulating the speed of the stones.
Dang. That was amazing, Penguinmon. Holy cow. Good job, Penguinmon. Oh my god. That was a great angle right there. Ah, I overshot that. I think this might be my first curling loss. How did he get a point for that? How does that count as a point?
It's like not even really inside the circle, yeah.
Oh no, that was dumb. I think I just gave him the game. I definitely just gave him the game. Wait. Okay, never mind. I didn't. Did you just give me the game? Almost. You almost just gave me the game. So, I want to hit my fat one down there. I'm gonna chance it. If this does not work, it did not work.
Your angle was off
Yeah.
by a bit. If you aimed it like a little bit more to the right, you might have hit it.
Wow, thank you, Penguinmon, thank you. I was going to
Why did
lose.
he do
I was
that?
going to lose. I was going to lose. So, I guess I'm
All he had to
still
do was aim for the
undefeated.
middle circle, he would have won.
I guess I'm still undefeated.
Penguinmon! What was up with that curling game?
Amazing, dude. Penguinmon, do you realize that you.
Do you know what you just did?
Penguinmon. Penguinmon.
Penguinmon, you klutz.
I don't even know what to say.
There's really nothing to say.
I think you can actually enter the curling.
It was network lag. It was his controller's
It
fault.
was his controller's fault. So after you recruit Penguinmon, you can actually come back in here. You can't do anything, but you can come back in here.
I mean, yeah, it's cool. It's an environment you can actually walk around in. I mean, I think most games would just kind of cut you off from it after that.
So I'm going to feed Biomon or Bergamon recovery because, I want to go back to a certain area in the Freezeland. And if I get into a battle, then Bergamon will die. Well, if I get into a battle and get hit, Bergamon will die. So, do I have any moldy meat? No, I do not. Okay. That sucks.
Can you get moldy meat?
Yeah, you can. You get it from a vending machine. It would just speed this process up to get, to recruit Frigimon. Because you need your Digimon to get sick in this area to recruit Frigimon. And if you give your Digimon moldy meat, they'll get sick eventually. And then that just speeds the process up.
Is that a care mistake?
I don't know if recruiting Frigimon counts as a care mistake. But yeah, getting your Digimon sick does count as a care mistake. I think because of the recruitment process, it just voids it or nullifies it. So there's a toilet here. If you ever need to poop in this ice cold place.
Come on, Bergamon. We don't want to get two rooms away, and then you gotta poop, and then we come one room back, and then you just drop it right in the middle of the way.
You know what would have been really cool? Seconds. Is if the poop over here was like, if it froze, it became like ice poop, and you could like pick it up and use it as an item or something.
Or does that just mean that instead of just chomping down on it, Tsukumon or Numemon would have to like shove a stick in it and just lick it?
Yeah.
You know, it sounds really gross when you put it that way though, but they're the poop mons, so.
I think I'll wait for Frigimon because it could take a while for Bergamon to get sick. So, if you come over here, you're not actually supposed to get this, but I think they just programmed it in a stupid way where if you enter this area through Freezeland, this defense chip is always there. But you're supposed to get this defense chip after you recruit a certain Digimon. But since I guess they failed programming something, you can just get it early on. So that's why I got it early on. I will try to fight Sanyamamon for the attack, and hopefully I don't lose. So let's try to learn Spinning Shot. Okay.
Well, may as well load state.
I don't think I can learn it right now. So why don't we just, go back to town? Wow! Bergamon is, a little bit weaker than I thought. Also, oh wait, we have to talk to Gigimon first.
I mean, it's kind of sad because Bergamon was just kind of wrecking everything before.
Yeah. Before we talk to, what's his face? Gigimon, let's actually go talk to Monochromon. So, after you recruit, either Monochromon, Patamon, Biomon, or Unimon, you get like a super big shop. And Punimon also comes in here. And once you recruit all of them, they all take turns. It's like a shift. Every couple of hours, they rotate. I don't need to sell anything else. But I do want to buy a few things. Let's buy... five portable potties. Let's buy... three autopilots. Let's buy... whole bunch of recovery discs. And a whole bunch of MP recovery discs. Let's go for 10. And I think I have no room, so... well, let's move this up here, and then let's deposit the defense chip. Okay, what day did I talk to Jumojimon, do you remember? I do not remember. So we'll check up on Jumojimon.
I don't think it's been like 3 days.
It's supposed to be 5 if you don't move the dirt.
That's what I'm saying. I'm saying I don't think it's anywhere near 5 days yet.
Okay, if that's the case, then also if Punimon's not here, you can still rest. I think I'm just gonna move the dirt. Just to get a little bit of extra bits and also those extra stat bonuses. Instead of waiting, I think that'll be better. Do I want to raise any stats before we go? Yes, I do, actually.
You might want to raise a lot of stats before you go, because Bergermon,
You are hungry, mister. I'm going to feed you. Of course. Oh wait, did I not deposit the defense chip? No, I did not. You're still hungry? Wow. Alright, so we'll try to raise brains to 200, maybe learn a new move. Probably not, but maybe. I also want to raise it to 200 because I learned a new battle command. Battle commands are pretty nice.
Actually made it to the toilet this time.
Yeah. Thank you, Bergermon. Oh, I can also, I will definitely learn Magma Bomb. Oh, you're hungry? Okay. The Gaburimon in Drill Tunnel actually use Magma Bomb the most. If, you have brains at a... like, if your brains are higher, you can learn moves in battle a little bit faster. If it's your first stat, like, you see special, there's fire, and then there's lightning. If it's your first stat, you have a base chance of 25%. As long as your brains are above 50, which they will be as long as you have a rookie. And if it's your secondary stat, you have 12.5% base chance of learning it. And you can sometimes have a third stat, but I guess the way that they made the game, it's impossible to learn it. Because it's like some number times 0% chance of learning it, which anything times 0 equals 0. So it's impossible to learn a move that they should theoretically be able to learn. So there's that.
Well,
I mean, if you have the move unlocked, you know, you can learn, you can, use it. Yeah, his brains are above 200, and that's what I wanted. Let's get our meats, and then let's try to learn Magma Bomb, and let's also help out Jumojimon with his dirt, unless he already finished, which I don't think he did.
I'm telling you, if it's daytime, by the time you go there, it'll be, like, day 3 since you've been there, is my guess. It could be day 2.
The thing is, I don't remember, so...
I don't either. I'm guessing it's been 3 days.
Well, what level did Bird Agumon did evolve? Level through H3? So now he's H6, so 3 days. Or did he digivolve at H4? I think he digivolved at H3. I can't believe Bergamon got completely destroyed by Sanyamamon. It wasn't even a fight. Bergamon's so happy. Just floating around, flying around. So first thing I'm gonna do is try to learn Magma Bomb. From these guys.
Now you said these guys use it a lot.
Yeah, these guys use it more often.
If a Digimon uses a particular move more often, does that increases your chance of learning it?
Well, no, they just have to use it on you, and, I mean, if they don't use the move all that often, then, you know, the chances of them actually attacking you with it is lower. So that's the only difference.
So when they use a move on you, it's all about whether or not your Digimon at the end of battle thinks like, huh, I could do that too.
Yeah, basically.
And if they do, you learn the move.
Yeah, basically. He attacked his friend! Oh my god!
Again?
That was purpose. He walked up to the Gaborimon. Also, I learned Moderate. When you get your brains above 200, you learn Moderate. Which I actually really like.
What's that
do? It just... You don't attack all that often. You don't it's like, you know, you moderate yourself. Essentially.
Okay.
I got a meat. You know what? Because I got a meat, I think I'll keep that in. Or, like, I won't load state. Let me see if What's-His-Face is finished. No, he's definitely not finished. So... Why don't we do this? Why don't we carry dirt, get into a battle with a Gaborimon, and see how Bergamon does fighting and carrying dirt. Wait, what? Oh. I guess you can't get
in. We're hoping to fight them and carry dirt.
I guess you can't. So, that's cool. Also,
I mean, I guess it's nice in case you accidentally bump into him.
In my, previous LP, I said that you need a champion to move the dirt. You don't need a champion to move the dirt. You need a champion to move the boulder, which is the next part of this, of, Jimojimon's thing. So you can move the dirt with a rookie. You just can't do the next part with the rookie. And that's because Miramon is pretty hard. So they don't want you to fight Miramon with a rookie. So yeah. And you get some bits and everything. I think you have to do... Move the dirt 15 times in total? Something like that. You can't do it in one day. Because, each time you bring dirt out, your Digimon's tiredness increases by 1 hour. Or one. And your Digimon can only get so tired before he doesn't want to move any more dirt.
It's almost like training, really.
Yeah. Basically.
Even if just a tiny bit.
But this is kind of like training, because you do get some stat bonuses.
Yeah.
Jimo, do you mind? 500 bits. 50 and 5. Man, Bergamon's really happy.
Well, I mean, he's being a productive member of society right now, so that could be part of it.
Maybe he really likes me. Or maybe it's a girl.
Well, you haven't treated it like garbage, so...
Except for the time that it pooped right next to Kunamon.
Look, that wasn't your fault. Bergamon couldn't hold it in.
Oh, Bergamon.
Have you rested yet?
I rested 1 hour, 1 hour, or like, once before I came here. So, Bergamon, and also...
So Bergamon has carried like...
Well, you can carry like, 10 in total. If your Digimon is fully rested, you can carry like, between like 9 and 11, usually at about 10. But that's if your Digimon is fully rested.
Okay, so when you did this in the stream with a 1 pound Garurumon, it was because he was basically on death's door that he could only do 2 at a time.
Yeah, he wasn't fully rested. And he also hated me. Oh, Garurumon.
Well, I mean, that's true. That didn't help matters.
How much does Bergamon weigh? 22 pounds. Oh, there's also a PAL version of this game. There's Japanese, there's the American, and then there's PAL. You can tell the difference between all of them, because there's different obviously you can tell the difference between Japanese, because it's Japanese. But you can tell the difference between PAL and American, because they use different fonts with everything written.
Wouldn't Japanese also technically be PAL, too?
Yeah, I guess. Wow. Bergamon, like... You really can carry a lot of dirt.
Yeah, jeez. Sure no sign of stopping.
And Bergamon, I mean, her face on the bottom right is just like, so happy.
She's just really thrilled to be carrying this dirt.
Well, I mean... If your Digimon likes the environment, then they also, you know, their face becomes like that. They like start smiling a lot, or like laughing, whatever you want, whatever that is.
Well, I mean, right past that tunnel is a fire area, isn't there?
Yeah, I mean, this whole area is kind of like a fire area, really. There's some water down
that
there.
That could be it.
And look, he's dug a little deeper now. I'm fairly certain that Bergamon won't be able to carry any more dirt. What? Okay, Bergamon. You're crazy.
Dude, Bergamon doesn't want to stop.
Bergamon's like, you know what? I can do this all in one go.
You know, maybe Bergamon took all that stuff I was saying about, like, get big and strong, eat big, get big, back when it was an Agumon, like, really seriously.
You know what else is weird? He hasn't asked for food or to poop.
Oh shit, is Bergamon dying?
Maybe he's just so happy that he doesn't want to think about that.
I mean, maybe, but... Like...
Oh no, my Digimon's finally tired. Oh, Bergamon.
Still carried a shit ton of dirt, though!
That was a lot of dirt. So if I, get into a battle now, there's a chance that my Digimon could, like, need a Band-Aid. Like, a Band-Aid would appear up above his head after the battle ends. And that would count as a care mistake.
Because it's just that tired.
Yeah. So, I mean, naturally I don't want that. I don't want my Digimon to get sick. Because that also reduces lifespan. If, you know, you treat, like, your Digimon gets sick and whatnot. Hey, there's Betamon. Let's see if Sunamon has anything to say. I was originally gonna talk to Gigimon, but there's an event that's gonna be happening soon, and I don't know if I have enough prosperity points, because I might, and I don't want to fight the Digimon with my current Bergamon, because I'm going to lose 100% and get owned. Did I get my meat for today? Yes, I did. I mean, I guess I could... Safe state?
Safe state.
Yeah. Alright, let's rest for a few hours. Oh, he's hungry now. But he doesn't have to poop.
She just finally realized that, like, she hadn't eaten for a whole day.
She was just having so much fun.
Carrying dirt.
Yep. Oh, he has to poop now. Well, I guess, Bergamon just really did have a lot of fun carrying all that dirt.
Bergamon had so much fun carrying that dirt, its metabolism just stopped. That's... How much fun do you have for that to happen?
I don't know. Also, Poyamon is over here. Did I mention that? The one in Gigimon's house by the AC?
I don't know if you did.
Oh yeah, but when you recruit Agumon, Agumon comes over here. Says the same thing.
Just to keep him company.
Yeah.
I mean, that bank looks like it gets pretty lonely.
Alright, let's rest one more time. I'll save state, talk to Gigimon. And if I meet the requirement, then I will load state. Bakumon came. Monochromon came. He's a professional. Penguinmon came. Oh, 11. Okay, good. I do not have too many. So I'll talk to Tanamon, because she might say something. Yep. After you get 10 prosperity points, Tanamon says something about a strange plant in the tropical jungle. And that's how you recruit the next person for me. But we can't do it yet because we have to wait for day 15. So, yeah. Also, after you get 10 prosperity points, and also after you've walked across the invisible bridge, there, Yuramon will tell you about bandits. Now, if we go back there, we can find bandits. I'm not going to do that just yet, but I just want to talk to Yuramon now. Just, you know, so I can get the prerequisite right there. And Penguinmon is not here yet. You actually need to recruit somebody else, which is Greymon, who opens the stadium before you can actually fight Penguinmon and then Curling. Because Penguinmon like, I guess, rents an area, rents a part of the arena from Greymon to start up his curling shop, battle arena thing. So yeah, we recruited Penguinmon and he's completely useless right now.
Well, I mean, at least you remain undefeated in curling.
I cannot believe Penguinmon.
So yeah, I mean, you can still take something away from this. Straight up gave you the game.
I know. What's wrong with him? I mean,
there's literally no reason that should have happened.
Something is totally wrong with Penguinmon. Anyway, I'm going to try to learn Magma Bomb one more time.
So, I mean, list of Digimon who will take a dive and you should never bet on them in anything. Penguinmon and Palmon.
Wait! Gaburimon attacked his friend again! That's Magma Bomb. Boom! It's a very powerful attack. It's one of the strongest, if not the strongest, early game attack you can learn. It has so much power. But it also costs a lot of MP. I mean, I can also learn the spinning attack that San Yamamon used, which is even stronger. But, you know, when you saw I got completely demolished. So it'll be a while before I learn spinning attack. Well, how about we get another overkill? Overkill!
So speaking of finishing the job, how much dirt do you think Bergemon's gonna be able to carry this time?
I hope the rest of it.
On a scale of 1 to fucking all of it.
Wait, did I learn? No! No, I got excited for nothing! But I got 2 meats, so I won't reload state. I got two meats. I thought I was gonna learn it. I thought it. Anyway, I think Bergemon will carry the rest of it. Unless Bergemon wants to go to sleep, in which case then I'll let Bergemon sleep. We'll feed you a giant meat, because you've been so nice to me. You get the big meat. Oh no! You're sleepy! No, I do not want to carry dirt, Bergemon. Can sleep. Do you have to poop?
It doesn't help that Bergemon seems to like this area.
Yeah. It doesn't. I really like how Bergemon sleeps. Sits down and just tilts her head to the side. I really like that.
Yeah, Bergemon sleeps like a bird. It's pretty fitting.
All the Digimon sleep slightly differently, and I'm glad that they did that. Because it makes each Digimon feel unique.
It is a nice touch.
I think Kabuterimon just falls over. I think you mentioned that on stream, that he just like falls over when he's going to sleep. There's like almost no dirt left.
How much more are you gonna have to carry? There's like only one more scoop left in there.
And you have to take all of it out. So, whatever. However many that is. But after I do get all the dirt, take all the dirt out, I'm going to go really hard on trying to learn Magma Bomb, because I really want to learn Magma Bomb. It'll make the Miramon fight really easy. Not just the Miramon fight, a few other fights that we will be going for. Pretty soon, but not quite yet, because we first need to recruit Miramon. So either this is the last one or there's one more. Okay, this is the last one. Good.
Yeah, it had to be because, like, it's not big enough for there to be more.
Well,
like, just comparing it to the size of the piles in the little... I don't know what I'd call that.
A crate, I guess. Well, it's not
really... Yeah, it works.
Not really a crate. I don't know. A minecart?
Pallet.
It looks more like a minecart, because I think there are wheels on the bottom. It could just be a pallet. Or, I mean, it doesn't have to be a minecart, it could just be a cart in general. I think there are wheels on there. Can we see? No? No? We can't? Okay.
Or it could just be a bucket.
Yeah, I guess.
Just a wooden bucket.
I want to know how Bergamon, like, carries that, though. Because there's no rope or anything.
Feet?
Yeah, maybe. So, after you move all the dirt, we just have to come back the next day, and... then we're done. Then we can go fight the Miramon. I'm gonna first get my meats from Palmon, and then I will try to learn Magma Bomb, and if I'm successful, you will see me with Magma Bomb. Oh, you're hungry. Oh, Bergamon. I'm stuck.
This is like the polar opposite of the streams, really.
Well, no, I treated Kabuterimon in the stream pretty nicely.
Bergamon is, Bergamon loves you. You're treating Bergamon well.
Bergamon carried so much dirt. And was not hungry, or...
didn't even phase it.
Yeah. Bergamon is just...
To be fair, Bergamon did weigh more than 1 pound.
Yeah, how much does Bergamon weigh now? Weigh 24 pounds. That's 24 Garurumons right there.
Just about.
Alright, let's just rest up a little bit. Try to get, cover my HP MP. Also recover a little bit of Bergamon's tiredness. And also waste a little bit of time, because each time you rest, you waste 1 hour.
How many hours are in a day?
24.
Oh, so it's just straight, okay.
Or 23. Is it? I'm pretty sure it's 24, but each hour is 1 minute. So a full day is, 24 minutes.
So is it easier to wait for the next day to come, or just rest 24 times?
Rest, because resting takes like 2 seconds.
Also, I guess you don't have to worry about any of your Digimon's needs at that point in time.
No, after you rest, they might have to poop or they might be hungry or something. Usually I just use a rest to waste a little bit of time, but then go back to training after I rest a little bit. So you get as many stats, increase your stats as much as possible. Should I raise Bergermon stats? You think that's a good idea? Maybe?
I mean, it couldn't hurt.
Let's put Bergermon in the water.
Okay, well that might.
I know you don't like that, Bergermon, so I won't do it again. Let's see how much you like getting hit in the face. Oh, you gotta poop.
Don't poop in the training field.
Yeah, it's probably not a good idea to do that. Let's raise HP. I guess we can go for like 2,000. Maybe I'll stand a chance against Sanyamamon with a little bit more health. Oh, Bergermon. No need to spaz out like that.
I think it was just like doing some kind of like enthusiastic dance. The Bergermon is super happy.
Yeah. I know. Bergermon really loves me.
Can't even contain itself.
Alright, over 2,000 health. You're gonna have to sleep soon. And let's try to learn Magma Bomb before you have to sleep. Oh, you're sleepy now. Okay. Fine. You can sleep now. I can also learn Magma Bomb from Miramon. But I'd rather just have Magma Bomb before I fight Miramon. Because Miramon is a little bit difficult. I mean, he's one of the easier champions, but he is a little bit difficult. I mean, obviously he's a champion. So, let's save state. We'll fight this Gaburimon instead of the other ones, because why not? Maybe this Gaburimon has the magical powers.
Over all the others? Is he the chosen one?
He might be.
Is he the one destined to walk you down this path?
So, I chose Moderate, and so from time to time, or what's happening is, basically, Bergermon is kiting Gaburimon right here. He's attacking, running away, attacking, running away, attacking, running away.
I mean, hey, if the strategy works.
I didn't get hit by Magma Bomb, but he did use it. And I think even if he, as long as he uses it, I think there's a chance to learn it. I've never learned it that way, but I think as long as that they attempt to use the attack, I think that's all that matters. I didn't get hit by it, so I don't know. And I also didn't learn it. Actually, we should probably go for Heat Laser, because there's three enemies on the screen.
How do you choose between which attacks you use?
When you get enough brains, you can just choose whatever attack you want. Aside from that, if you choose attack, he uses the strongest attack. If you choose your call, he uses whatever you want. If you use moderate, he usually goes for the fastest attack. There's defensive, where he mostly focuses on defense, but I think he also goes for his like weakest or fastest attack. What else is there? I don't remember the other. the other commands. There's change, but change doesn't do anything except for change targets. I got Borimon just stopped moving.
Well, I mean, he didn't want to get hit by his friend.
Please, can I learn
guess.
Magma Bomb? Please? Yes!
Oh, hey, there we go.
Two meets and a Magma Bomb.
Finally.
Finally. It actually didn't take all that long. I mean, it's long, but, you know, for this game, it's not that long.
I mean, it felt long because we carried, like, a shit ton of dirt in between.
Yeah, that too. So, this, Drillmon takes a while. You need to talk to a certain Digimon, which is Leomon. And then you need a certain number of prosperity points and a few other things. And then I think you need to have you need to have Ogremon recruited. Not the last Ogremon. Because there's only really one Ogremon. And I guess this is technically spoilers, but I mean, this game is old and I've also already LP'd it in the past. So I'm assuming that you have some, I mean, the viewers have some knowledge of this game. So you need a champion to move this boulder. That's why Cat, or my character, was like, I don't know if I can move this boulder. But, I don't know why Jimojimon doesn't just dig through this hole. I mean, dig through the rock.
Or maybe get, like, the other Jimojimons, like, hey, I got a really hard rock. And they all drill through it together.
We can't come down here yet. But after we fight Miramon, we can go down there. So that's like a little invisible wall for the time being. And let's see. Alright, I have one open slot, which sucks because I think there's a whole bunch of treasure chests here. Roar! Well, after you beat Miramon, another area opens up for us. So we can advance. Oh, I didn't equip Magma Bomb! Oh, I'm such a dumbo!
Time load state!
I didn't save state after I learned Magma Bomb.
Oh no! Time to deal without it.
Oh no! I mean, look at Bergemon. Bergemon just like... Look at this, man. Bergemon's pretty good.
Yeah, really.
Should do over 800. 834. Oh, he was gonna go for a Megaton Punch. Or, I mean, looked like more like a kick. Or maybe it was just Sonic Jab.
Really like whittling his health down pretty quick too.
I know. He's like barely able to do anything to me.
That's weird. Sometimes Bergemon is like really good, and other times Bergemon's like, Bergemon, come on.
Well, it's also because I have the moderate command, so Bergemon's like kiting Miramon. And it's just kind of awesome. Dude, Miramon, where are you going?
I think he's just done. He doesn't want to deal with it anymore. You're either going to fight him for real or you're going to keep screwing with him, and he doesn't want to deal with it.
Bye, Miramon. Alright, let me equip Magma Bomb now. Yay!
Yay!
Miramon opens a shop. No, you know what? Let's do highest to lowest. Why not? And there's a thing here, but I don't think I have any room to take any of this stuff. No room for that. So, I'll have to come back here later because I won't be able to get all of the treasure chests. And, there's no more lava. Man, you can talk to these demi-Miramons. Some of them tell you stuff, some of them are like, hey, trade me this card for this card. And there's this Jumojumon that I want to talk to. You just have to sort of talk to him and then eventually he'll finish digging. Or drilling, really. And then he'll join your city. I don't think I can take any of this stuff, yeah. Because I have to come back here, I'm just, not going to go ahead and talk to the other, Demi-Miramons, because I'm gonna have to come back here anyway. Take the autopilot! You just take the dang autopilot. There you go. Yay!
Oh hey, it's a restaurant.
Yeah, from Miramon.
So does that mean that Miramon, when he cooks, he doesn't use a stove?
That's what I've always assumed.
He just, like, puts his hand under the pan he's cooking with?
That's what I've always assumed, so I don't know.